instantly enthused about what you want to do. You just get on with it. And it's such a magic place to go and relax. I can't paint for more than half an hour at a time because I put so much emotion and energy into it that I go down, have a cup of tea in our courtyard, which is so relaxing, so beautiful. You could be anywhere in the world you want to be. So it's, I'm really, really lucky discovering this place. I just love it, I love the people. The place, perfect, really perfect.
Being someone that works from home on your own is quite isolating, so actually being a volunteer in the shop, getting to meet the public, getting to meet other artists and just people who appreciate, you know, the local art scene has been fantastic. I can't imagine not working here. I really think that the cafe has really helped to bring in, get people in through the doors, get them seeing the art and experiencing art in Maidstone as well, which is something we really lack. So yeah, I think
it's people that wouldn't normally even think about coming into a gallery now actually come in and have a coffee, and gradually each time we've got several people that come in that probably art isn't their forte or their interest, but who are now beginning to walk around and look around the gallery. So it does definitely break down those sorts of barriers.
Yeah. The sun's come out beautifully, and it's just this lovely different mix of people coming in as well, different people that wouldn't normally come in, hearing the music, and you know, and then they're coming in, it's brilliant. We've got a magician walking around, we've got to hear bands, we have singers, it's kind of, you know, a mix of everything really, so it's quite good. They've been doing festivals every year for years now, I think, since almost since the beginning of Nucleus Arts. So, and we've got three, we had three this year.
I just wanna know if you're gonna